So we think about the next 5 years. What are some things that you think an average human being will be able to experience that they cannot right now?
A whole host of new medicines. The capacity of some of these new systems that we're developing is so high that we're spitting out molecules with properties that we didn't even know existed. I mean, you know, we're making them. So I suspect that we will have a whole host of new medicines. Great opportunity. I suspect that some diseases, which were very difficult to cure before, will have, with a combination of gene therapy and with new medicines, be curable. We're already seeing that. Diseases like spinal muscular atrophy, a rare disease, but debilitating, used to, basically almost, it was almost certainly deadly. A single injection or a couple of injections of one drug has completely reversed that. These children are now walking and will probably continue to walk for the rest of their lives. So a huge change there. I think that, we will also see more prosthetics, and we will arm ourselves, these are opportunities, we will arm ourselves with a much wider system of information. Again, enhanced with digital and AI tools, which will expand our capacities. Those are the opportunities. So we will become smarter. We will become hopefully more disease resistant. We will have larger memory banks. And we will have the capacity to interact in the virtual sphere in a way we cannot just simply interact in the real sphere.
And as we see human beings becoming more digitally interactive, right, including directly with chips being implanted inside human beings, what does that look like in a few years' time? What are the capabilities that people may have, good or bad, that they don't have now?
So I'll talk about the good. I mean, as I said, imagine someone who has been paralyzed by a stroke. Imagine someone who can't speak because they have Lou Gehrig's disease. And all of a sudden, with these capabilities, they're able to do that. There are already programs that exist. People with strokes, people with paralysis, people with movement disorders, people with anything that requires prosthetics. Number two, I think our memory is limited. Our memory of our social interactions is limited. Now that, imagine that multiplied by n-fold.
How does that happen?
Well, you can start. I mean, it's already happening. So the simple example right now is how much memory do you store in real life versus your iPhone?
No, sure, understandable.
Sure. Imagine that multiplied by 10,000-fold. Imagine that multiplied by 100,000-fold. Imagine, and this was a conversation I was having yesterday. Imagine being able to have a communication, a real communication, with the simulacrum of someone who's passed away, with your in my case, with my father who passed away. Imagine I could create.
Black Mirror has had that episode. By
I know.
The way, so yeah.
But that's no longer a Black Mirror episode. Right. It is becoming and will become a reality. And these are not fantastical. I'm not making up technologies. These are technologies that are, one hand's reach away. And the question is, do we reach or do we not reach?